you guys, Evangelist Robb here of Robb Woods Ministries, and want to decree and declare that I see the Lord dispatching angelic hosts, angels, different types of angels over you in this season, over your loved ones. The Lord is dispatching guardian angels, many different seraphim, there's different kinds of angels in the Bible. Listen, I would guesstimate there's untold billions, hundreds of billions, trillions of angels. Now, there's also fallen angels, demons, that want to try and hurt, wound, divert, kill you. They hate you because the devil hates you because you're washed by the blood. But the angels of God carry great power of protection. I'm thinking of Gehazi, Elijah's servant. They go to bed at night. The young man is freaking out. He's all nervous. He wakes up in the morning. He sees the enemy surrounding him. And the Lord, the prophet says, open the young man's eyes. And it said, when his eyes were open, he seen angels of fire, chariots of fire surrounding the enemy. And he came to the revelation. He said, there are more that are for us than those that are against us. I want to prophesy to you. There are more angels that are for you than demons that are against you. Because God's for you, who or what can be against you? Now listen to me. I'm not worshiping angels. I'm not teaching the worshiping of angels. Jesus, an angel would appear sometimes to a person, a patriarch in the Bible, and the angel would say, don't worship me, worship him. They would always point to Jesus. Don't worship me, worship him. Don't look to me, look to him. But there are roles, and let's not underestimate it and become like, oh, wow, I don't want to get into angels. And God hasn't called us to get into angels. I'm going to make it clear he's called us to get into Jesus. Now, we've got to be careful that we never use encounters to establish doctrine. We only use scripture to establish doctrine. So we're not looking for visions or encounters. I see sometimes something in this generation where they crave encounters. They crave the supernatural. God hasn't called us to crave the He's called us to go after Jesus. And as a result, the Lord can and will give us encounters, but we don't look to them. Praise the Lord. I had to shut my phone off. Excuse me. By the way, it'd be an honor if you're new, please subscribe. If you're new, also every Monday, 9 p.m., I'm live prophesying, preaching, praying the word of the Lord. Come on, the Monday night chat's blowing up. Now, let me read to you Psalms 91 in about 2 minutes. I want to pray for the angelic dispatching of angels to come over you. Now, we can't really assign angels. The Lord can only assign angels as he sees fit, but we do thank the Lord for them. Psalms 91 says, he who dwells in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. The secret place is not necessarily a place in the natural. It's a place in the spirit realm that we come to, where we enter into what the Lord has already done. We enter into a rest and an assurance that God is for us and not against us. Verse 4, he shall cover you with his feathers. Under his wings you shall take refuge. Father, we thank you. There's angels. They're on assignment. Cherubim, seraphim, different kinds, myriads of angels in the Bible. The Bible says, aren't all angels ministering spirits sent to those who will inherit salvation? Aren't all angels sent to those to protect us, to guide us, to give us direction? Most of all, Father, I'm asking angels, I thank you for angels that are around me, my family, my loved ones, and I'm thanking you for angels that are around anyone listening and watching and viewing this show in the name of Jesus. The Bible says we ought not to be careful that we don't entertain an angel's unaware. You know, I've heard of stories, people break down in a car, a man comes with a can of gas, and they turn around and the man's gone. You know, like, where's the man with the can of gas? you know, and it could have been an amen. It could have been an angel. People in accidents sometimes. I heard a story. A man was being crushed. A truck fell on him. He was a mechanic on a lift, and angels came and lit. I mean, look, guys, listen, come on. There's a spiritual realm that we are not aware of sometimes that's real. So, hey, the Lord bless you guys in Jesus' name.